invited to make any representations. A ward councillor can address the committee in relation to an application. The ward councillor may speak on behalf of the resident. However, once the ward councillor has returned to the public gallery, they may not return to take part in any debate that may follow by the committee. The application will then be open to debate and discussion by members of the planning committee, who will then make a decision on the application. The order of tonight's agenda may be varied subject to the numbers of people who are here in relation to a specific agenda item and subject to the committee agreeing to this being varied. If a site visit is requested and approved by the committee, that matter will not be discussed this evening and will be discussed at a subsequent planning meeting.
Thank you.
to level 4 and 7, but it looks like we're having site visits for those now, so we'll just stick to if that's okay. Okay, so the first item is agenda item 5, which is land off the A5 for Wallasey Village, pages 13 to 20. We can have a presentation, please.
Planning permission is sought for a new signalised junction giving access off the A554 into West Wallasey Fleet Hire site. The works will involve a new access across a small grass verge and will also involve a widening of the carriageway to allow for sufficient visibility displays. The site is located in the Greenbelt. No provision for highway works in the Greenbelt is set out in UDP policy GB2. However, regard should be had to the National Planning Policy Framework, which indicates that engineering works and local transport infrastructure in a greenbelt location are not inappropriate if openness is preserved. A new access to the site will allow for the loading and unloading of vehicles within the site rather than on adjacent highways and within a largely residential environment. The current proposals follow lengthy discussions with council highways officers and represent the best solution to a long-standing amenity issue for local residents. A site-specific flood risk assessment has been undertaken and the proposals have been considered by the lead local flood authority and the environment agency, and the development can be carried out without any risk of flooding in or around the site or elsewhere. The proposed development is considered to be acceptable in terms of design, road safety and highway capacity, and represents an opportunity to improve the amenities for local residents. The proposals are recommended for approval and there's no petition.
This is a welcome improvement to the area. This has caused a lot of congestion for some time now, so this is a dramatic improvement and I'm certainly happy to give it my full support.
Thank you, David. Ian?
Thank you, Chair. Just two questions if I may to the highways officer in terms of this. The current access that is used by West Wallasey is at Cross Lane, which feeds onto Lisa Road, where we know that there's a number of accidents over the years and problems with congestion. Is the proposal, as far as the highways department is concerned, if this application is approved, does that mean that there won't be any works at this junction to improve safety? Or does the department have anything in the pipeline to deal with the issues that have been raised by residents and ward councillors over the last 10 years?
Thank you. Through you, Chair. I don't think that this proposal will make it will alter the issues around the traffic signals across Lane. I'm not aware of any proposals at the moment to carry out any works there, but if this junction that we're looking at today were to be approved and built, I don't see that it's going to alter any future need for the improvements of the junction across Lane. So I don't see a prejudice in any potential future work for that junction.
Following on from that then, one of the comments that's been raised by, I think, on page 14, point one of the representations makes reference to WL lines being installed on Cross Lane at this particular junction. Could you give us your view on that, please?
Yes, thank you for you, Chair. We're not proposing to provide any yellow lines at Cross Lane at the moment. In developing this proposal that's before us, before you today, the applicants asked the applicant to look at the issues around Cross Lane and why they couldn't use that as an access. And one of the issues was the parking, but also the width of the road isn't sufficient really for the size of vehicles that they're going to be using. So in addition to removing the parking, there'd be a need to widen the road. The issues you've got there then is it involves third party land which complicates the whole thing.
I'm sorry, Leslie, I couldn't see you sitting there. Did you want to speak on this at all?
No, not really. Okay. I don't need to speak in support of it, so I'm with the authorities.
Okay, alright, I do apologise. Okay, well, the officer's recommendation is to approve something.
application was the subject of a member's site visit on Tuesday. Permission is sought for the use of the annex for bed and breakfast. The conversion works have already taken place and there is evidence online that suggests the annex is already available for bookings in association with paying guests. Therefore, the proposals are being considered to be retrospective. The annex is laid out with two bedrooms, a bathroom, a kitchen living room. The annex has its own access and off-road parking space and a small courtyard located at the front of the property. The annex is small-scale and residential in character and provides for short-stay accommodation. It is considered that this modest guest house facility would contribute positively to the economy of the area, and although it is likely to result in some increase in car usage to and from the area, the overall residential character of the area will be maintained. Clearly, the pattern of usage of the annex as bed and breakfast would be different to that of an ancillary residential use. However, given the modest size of the unit, it is considered that the use will have a minimal impact in terms of the comings and goings of people using the annex for bed and breakfast. It is considered unlikely that the use would impact adversely on the amenities of adjoining residents, and it is considered to be acceptable and is therefore recommended for approval. A non-qualifying petition of objection signed by 19 signatures was submitted to full council on the 6th of March by Councillor Ray.
Is there a ward council would like to speak on this? If you just state your name for the minutes and you have up to 5 minutes to speak. Thank you, Chair and Councillor Leslie Rennie, and I represent Wallasey Ward. First of all, can I thank the committee members and also the officers for taking time out on, I think it was Tuesday, when you came along to the site visit on this. Thank you very much indeed. And as the planning officer has quite rightly said, there was a petition, but clearly it didn't have the qualifying number of people to warrant petitioners speaking here tonight. Hence, petitioners have asked me to go through a number of the points which they would like raising and would like me to take into consideration. Clearly from what the planning officers have already said, and clearly from what is detailed within the report, there's an extremely long planning history in relation to this particular dwelling. As I say, it's fully there for everybody to see in the report. I think personally, and I have, after talking to a number of residents, that they quite likely have a right to be concerned about this particular planning application. Over the years, the residents have been fairly tolerant, in my view, about the applications which have come forward for this particular property. They did object on a number of occasions. Some of the planning history relates to applications which were successful and approved, others were refused. And only quite recently, there was an appeal to the planning inspectors on the last planning application submitted on behalf of this property. There are discrepancies clearly within the findings, I would contest, of that particular representation to the planning inspectors, inasmuch as from what I can deduce, it was outside the guidelines for the planning inspector to look at it, but clearly I understand further that they have jurisdiction to obviously make that decision themselves. But clearly, again, there is a history of flouting of petitions, of permissions which have been given over the years. And now residents are faced with the possibility that the permission which was given for a granny flat is now actually the subject of this planning application tonight, in as much as the owners want to have a bed and breakfast there to accommodate up to four people. And again, speaking with plenty of local residents, they tell me that actually this is already being used for that purpose at the moment, and therefore I would contest that the owner is clearly out of order and is flouting once again the previous permissions that he has had, in fact to only use it as a granny flat. The residents, as you will be aware, are up in arms about this. Broadway Avenue is a residential road. It's a very nice area of Wallasey, and I realise that doesn't necessarily come into planning legislation, that fact, but it is also, with it being a road full of substantial houses, in that area really, I believe, should be able to enjoy the peace and quiet of their own homes, and that hasn't been able for them over the last couple of months, because clearly the bed and breakfast is now already up and running, and residents have told me that there are a number of instances where there has been parties in the very small courtyard going on till all hours of the early morning, and clearly that is totally unacceptable. Any change of use officially for this particular building, this annex, therefore, I would say would only make that situation even worse. So I would be asking tonight for the committee to perhaps consider not approving this tonight. I think the intensity of the impact of this proposed use of this dwelling would only have a detrimental effect on the area and onto the residential area. And I think there must be something, I mean, I've never been on the planning committee, thank goodness, but there has to be something within the Wirral UDP that surely members can find here to turn this down. And I would ask the committee here to refuse this application tonight. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can I just open this to the committee now and come out from the committee?
Thank you, Chair. I'm slightly disappointed that I understand why the action on Dickie Lewis's was withdrawn for a site visit, because I believe some of the issues are similar to this particular application, in the sense that we're looking at a development being turned into very intensive levels of occupation. It was disappointing on the site visit. It's disappointing on the site visit that we couldn't get access to the property to see how a one-bedroom property would be suitable to four people to stay in orbit for short periods of time, which is an argument that we've made similarly in the past when it comes to HMOs in terms of the intensity of occupation. For the people who live on Broadway Avenue, there would be no difference other than the fact that it would be different people coming and going throughout that time. Property is advertised on Airbnb. That fact was brought to the attention of the planning department, and then hey presto, the owner submits the planning application in order to prevent any enforcement activity while that application is considered and brought before us tonight. Having visited the site, those of us who were there will see it is primarily a residential area. For a property of this size, which was granted permission for a granite flat, which is perfectly understandable, when you look at the property itself and the location, but on the location map you can see the close proximity of this property to neighbours, and for that reason, Chair, I feel this application is over the intensity of development in the residential area, and so I'll be looking to move refusal.
Is anybody else trying to speak on this before?
Obviously glad to eventually got to the site visit, and it was quite enlightening. Clearly there's some clash here of what planning is saying, because we've only just learned very recently that an application was put in for permanent residency, or use of permanent residence, and that has been granted by the inspector. So perhaps one could create an argument to say, having that permission being granted, that actually family living there 24/7, 365 would be more intense than sporadic use of a bed and breakfast, because most bed and breakfasts aren't always full and aren't always occupied. So one could equally make the argument that a bed and breakfast or a small business there would actually be less intensive than a permanent family living there, which is now being granted. So my view is, I'm listening intently to the reasons for refusal. I do go back many years as a young lad approaching the environs of New Brighton, and lots of properties were converted to bed and breakfast when New Brighton was in its heyday. This may be a sign that the renaissance of New Brighton is beginning to attract people to come back to New Brighton on a short stay or a longer stay visit. I don't know. This is only one application we've seen, but But I remember, you know, that's how people made livings and made employments in the area by developing those sort of things. So it's a difficult decision. Would I be happy to stay there for a couple of nights as a BB if I had friends or relatives or wanted to go and spend some more time on Merseyside? Possibly. So it does perhaps fill a need that might be necessary for the renaissance of me Brighton. So we're listening intently to the reasons for Jude, but I'm inclined, given it's now got permission to be permanently occupied, that a B&B may be less intense.
David?
Yes, thank you, Chair. Having gone on the site visit, it does look totally inappropriate for the area, but I'm also minded to consider the two aspects that we've got, the two reasons we've got tonight for not considering a couple of applications which are HMO related, and both of those are going to relate, I believe, to over-intensification of use. We've already turned down the conversion of the police station within the last few weeks at Cllr Street because we felt, again, apart from anything else, it was over-intensification of use. There is no amenity value here at all, and in my view, I don't think the planning department of this borough should be encouraging over-intensified use of any sort, whether it's an HMO or whether it's trying to cram people, however temporary, bed or breakfast or whatever, into such a small space. I think it's distasteful. I don't think it's the sort of thing that, as a planning committee of all political persuasions, we should be encouraging. I don't believe it's an appropriate solution for that area, and I think on this occasion I need to hear what my planning committee colleague has to say with regard to moving refusal, but I'm trying to pursue that solution and refuse it for the right reasons. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, David. Could I just ask members to try and not compare applications on the basis of we should be looking at each individual application and turn that. Thank you.
Sure.
Okay, so anybody else who wants to speak on this? Treena?
Just very quickly, I wasn't trying to compare. All I was trying to make the point was that we do have similar situations to consider with over-intensification. There was no intention to do anything other than consider this one on its own, using the merits at a unique location. Thank you.
Sorry, through you, Chair. I think we have to be very careful because members have deferred two applications tonight for site visits, and we're starting to make comments on those applications before those applications have had the chance to be considered, and also to make the point that this isn't an application for an HMO, it's an application for bed and breakfast, so we do need to be very careful about what's said at this point.
Just one final point, I was referring really to Cllr Street, but I was concerned, and what I was trying to do for those present was make the point that we should be encouraging over-intensification. And in my view, this particular one, not the others we're going to see, but this particular one follows the Cllr Street pattern that we have already refused as being over-intensified. I'll leave it at that, Chair. Thank you for pointing out my errors and my errors of my ways. I'll try to learn from them.
If the basis of the argument that's going to be issued is that it's comparing it to HMO, then we're not dodgy territory.
Regardless of ownership, because ownership is a family seat. This is a one-bedroom property that will not near the coast. You'd have to get a train and get two stops to get to New Brighton. I don't see this. I believe that the planning history on this particular site gives the indication as to the purpose for this application tonight, in that the applicant is clearly wanting to make money on this particular development. That's, I understand that, you know, I get that, and again, that's not a planning consideration. But I would say that this is over-intensity for a one-bedroom, single-storey property with literally no garden, a courtyard up front behind a high wall, on a junction of this nature. It invites problems. It invites problems because it is not designed, this building was not designed to be a bed and breakfast. We granted planning permission some time ago for a granny annex. A granny annex implies one person or an elderly couple in a one-bedroom property. That was acceptable, that was approved. Four people staying, for no matter how long they're staying in a one-bedroom property, is not acceptable. And so what I'd like to do, Chair, unless there's anybody else through you, I'll have to move refusal.
The office has actually just pointed out to me that it has been checked on the website regarding the bed and breakfast aspect of this, and it is advertised as two bedroom, and it's actually shown beds in two rooms within the property. So I just really wanted to point out that comment before you move your refusal.
Well, in that case,
yeah,
if there are two bedrooms, that's the alternative, to a bathroom, a kitchen, and two bedrooms. Yeah. Which again is, you know, is not acceptable to the users.
Just to clarify, there are two separate bedrooms and a managed living room.
Not on the plan, is
it? Not on the plan, but on the website, it's clear.
You see now, so this chair is the point, because this is the applicant doing one thing and saying another. On the plans that were approved by this authority, it is a one bedroom property. That was quite clear on the previous application. So, Chair, with permission, I'd like to move refusal for the following grounds. That the change of house to bed and breakfast would be likely to result in an intensification on the use of the site with associated increased intermittent noise and disturbance at close quarters for the occupiers and neighbouring and nearby dwellings, contrary to the amenity objectives of the National Planning Policy Framework. The use also has the potential to accommodate up to four guests at any one time, with the resulting comings and goings of patrons, including the potential for activity at antisocial hours, especially during the summer months, when noise may also arise from the use of the front patio area by patrons. The intervening boundary fence will provide only limited sound attenuation. The intensity and impacts of the proposed use will be materially different from a single dwelling, and as such, the use is considered to be contrary to policy HS 15 of the Wirral Unitary Development Plan.
Okay, Councillor Lewis has moved refusal. Do you have a second? David? All those in favour of refusal? I think that's counted as refusal. Sorry. Is there anybody voting against or abstaining? Voting against?
On the basis that this was your second BAB that you were in the world.
Perfect.
You're a BAB, but it's easy to support our nation.
And you were able to have your vote, and we respect your opinion. Okay, if we can move on now to agenda item 8, Heswell Nursery on pages 30 through 40. Matthew, could you have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. Planning permission is sought for amended designs to three detached dwellings originally approved on 24th of July 2015. Earlier amendments to the design were subsequently approved by committee on the 11th of April 2016. The dwellings which are currently under construction have been measured on site following concerns that ridge heights have been increased, but I am able to confirm that dwellings have been constructed in accordance with the details approved in April 2016, and this application does not increase the ridge heights further. The changes now relate to amended window design to the front of each dwelling, resulting in an additional pane of glass for the master bedroom and lounge windows, thereby altering the window from three panes to four, and the insertion of three balanced roof lights on the rear roof plane of each dwelling. These minor changes are considered to be acceptable and would not result in a change to the character of the dwellings taken in their overall context, and would not result in any additional overlooking or loss of privacy. The proposal is considered acceptable and recommended for approval. There is no petition or objection submitted with this application.
Is there any more councillors to speak on this? No? Okay, can I open this up to the committee, please? Any comments? No?
Just
David?
Thank you, Chair. Just very briefly, what is going on here seems to be an enhancement and an improvement on the application that we approved previously. Plus the fact most of the reason for objection relate to the original application, not to what we're looking at this time. So I'm happy to support this revised design. Thank you, Chair.
Are you moving that then?
Yes. Move approval based on the officer's recommendations.
Okay. The second of the Ian. All those in favour of approval, subject to conditions listed? That's unanimous. That's carried. We now move on to agenda item 9 to Shrewsbury Road, pages 41 to 44. If we could have a presentation, please.
Again, this was an application that was subject to a member's site visit on Tuesday. Planning Commission has sought the erection of a single storey rear extension, a new access, and erection of boundary fence. The extension is single storey with a sloping roof and will be built across the width of the rear of the existing property. The single storey extension looks out onto the application site. Whilst the extension will move closer to the rear elevation of the property at the rear, 30 Broadway Avenue, there would be no loss of amenity or overlooking due to the boundary treatment of a 2 metre high fence that separates the two properties. 30 Broadway Avenue has also been extended at the rear with a single storey extension, conservatory and a large roof dormer. Properties to the side at 29 Sedbergh Road would not be impacted on due to their single-storey nature of the proposal. The new access and driveway in itself does not require planning permission, as Shrewsbury Road and Sedbergh Road are not classified roads. However, additional details of the access are conditioned to deal with the issue of crossing a dropped curb. The proposals are considered to be acceptable and are recommended for approval. Again, there's no petition in connection with this application.
Thank you, Matthew. Is there more council like to speak on this? That's it. You're in the hot seat tonight.
Thank you again, Chair, and also, you know, again, thank you for the time spent coming out to have a look at this. I was asked by literally dozens of people if I would use my authority in having this taken out of delegation. So it's rather disappointing, really, to see that at the end of the day there are only four objections for this. But nevertheless, the
now move to agenda item 10, which is on pages 45 to 50, Cllr Farm on Cottabridge Road. Matthew, if you can have a presentation, please.
Thank you, Treena Chair. Planning permission is sought for two modest extensions to the side and rear south facing elevation. The side extension will involve a 3 metre projection off the existing elevation and will measure 12 metres in length and will allow for an increased kitchen. The single storey south elevation extension will also measure 12 metres in length and project 6 metres from the existing elevation and will provide for additional cafe space. The National Planning Policy Framework continues to advise that new buildings in the Greenbelt should be considered as inappropriate. However, exceptions at paragraph 89 of the National Planning Policy Framework now include provisions for the extension and alterations of a building, provided it does not result in disproportionate additions over and above the size of the original building. As the proposed extensions are relatively small scale and would not have any detrimental impact, it is not considered they would result in disproportionate additions above the size of the original building. The extensions are single storey and relatively small scale, and would appear subordinate and in keeping with the existing host building. The design and materials reflect the original building and would not detract from the open character of the Greenbelt. The proposals are recommended for approval, and again, no petition in connection with this development.
Thank you, Matthew. Could I just ask the members of the public that are still here, which application have you come for?
It's number 12.
Number 12, we're actually going to go out to the site visit for that particular application.
Can I ask why?
What was the reason given? Can Clark tell us, please?
Residents could say
that. A number of residents have raised concerns.
We're moving in there on Monday. It hasn't got a kitchen.
I'm really sorry, but we can't go into the debate of this. We have had to refer it to a site visit. The site visit will take place on the 20th of June. If you are able to leave the chambers if you'd like to know. We won't be discussing it this evening.
Can I just ask you to...
I'm sorry, I can't get into discussion with you over there, sorry.
Planning permission is sought for the demolition of an existing garage and the erection of a new detached garage to the rear of the site. The new garage will be marginally larger than the existing to be demolished. The remaining garden area will therefore largely be the same, although the new garage is located in a new position. Given its location at the rear of the site, it will not be visible from the street scene, and the existence of boundary fencing and hedging will mean the garage will be screened from view from neighbouring properties. There will be no loss of amenity or privacy, and the application is recommended for approval. There is no qualifying petition of objection.
And we don't have a ward councillor here to speak on this, so can I open this up to committee, please?
Can I move approval, please? Move approval, Chair, in accordance with the officer's recommendation.
Okay, did anybody else want to speak on that? No, okay, so Dave's moving, and Eddie will second that again. Okay, all those in favour of approval, subject to the conditions listed?
about the